It's a great pleasure to have you with us this evening, especially knowing that many of you have probably traveled thousands of kilometers to be here tonight. Before making a few remarks, I want to thank the many people who have worked so hard to make this graduation weekend special. Ms. Natalie Philpott has been in charge of the overall coordination and has done an outstanding job. Please give Ms. Philpott a round of applause. The dean of our 12th grade, Mr. Peter Locke, also has worked extremely hard to make this weekend a very special one for all of you. So Mr. Locke, let's give a round of applause. And last, but by no means least, I want to thank our chefs, our catering and service staff, our maintenance and our housekeeping staffs, and so many others for transforming this Palestra and serving this, I think, really amazing meal this evening. Please, a warm round of applause. As I thought about making a brief speech tonight, I was reminded of a speech given by the surrealist artist Salvador Dali. He said, "I will be so brief, I've already finished." And then he sat down. I think you have to be a bit quirky and famous, perhaps, to get away with that. I'm sorry, but no such luck tonight. This is my 19th graduation banquet at TASIS, both here and in England. And I always like to start off by giving a few statistics about the graduating class so that you can get a feel for this amazing group of young people. So who are the graduates of the TASIS class of 2016? There are 123 seniors and PGs in the graduating class, the largest class in the history of TASIS. Young women outnumber young men 72-51. I don't know why all the young women are cheering on that, but 82 of our graduates are boarding students and 41 are day students. 12 of this year's graduates are in their first and their only year at TASIS. And a record number of 52 graduates, almost half of the class, have spent their entire 4 years of high school here at TASIS. Quite amazing. And two graduates have attended TASIS for 11 years, starting in second grade in 2005 when the elementary school opened. With Kereni Siegel and Paul Noel, please stand. 11 years. Wow. This year's graduates represent 29 different countries, countries that have 10 or more graduates in the class of 2016. Are the United States, Italy, Russia, Brazil, Switzerland, and Turkey. Tonight, I will end my review of the graduating class with a few rather remarkable and unusual statistics. 6 members of this class are children of TASIS alumni from the 1980s. Chetikal, Alois de Bruin, Isabel Gavage, Emma Harsak, Alex Jordan, and Daphne Sahe. With these seniors, please stand to be recognized. Tomorrow, we will start a new tradition with the children of TASIS alumni receiving their diplomas from their parents tomorrow. Another unusual statistic, in my 27 years as a headmaster, this is the first time that I have ever had the pleasure of having triplets in the graduating class. Would Alaria, Galaida, and Joanna Aaron please stand up? And I'm not finished yet. Not only are there triplets in this class, there also are quadruplets. Although their brother, Gio Romano, will be graduating from a school in California next week, his three sisters are members of the TASIS class of 2016. Would Antonella, Gabriella, and Isabella Piconi please stand up? Yes, the class of 2016 is a remarkable group. And tomorrow, May 28th, is a very special day indeed. And not just because it's graduation day, there are also some anniversaries to celebrate. On a personal note, tomorrow is my wedding anniversary. Sharon, my wife Sharon and I were married 34 years ago tomorrow at TASIS, England. And a couple of months after our wedding, we moved here to Lugano when I started my first tenure as headmaster of TASIS. I hope that Sharon enjoys the intimate luncheon for several hundred people that I planned for tomorrow. And speaking of anniversaries, as many of you know, this year also is the 60th anniversary of the founding of TASIS, when Mrs. Fleming started her big dream in 1956. And one final anniversary, 20 years ago, 1996, my wife Sharon had the honor of giving the graduation speech here in Lugano. I remember it vividly. It was a beautiful Ticino day, sunny and warm, and the ceremony was held outside with the view of the mountains. Sharon entitled her speech, Journeys and Strangers. And she talked a lot about the millions and millions of decisions and twists of fate that brought all of us, graduates, parents, teachers, and guests, to this spot at this time. Well, this is something that I also have thought about quite often. For example, graduates, why have I had the good fortune of being here at this time to be part of your final year at TASIS? Although I wish that I had the opportunity to get to know all of you better than I did, I'm honored to have been part of your TASIS experience. And why have all of you ended up together in this place at this time? Yes, it's all rather mind-boggling if you think about it too much. There's part of me that thinks we were destined to be together in this community this year. That we were destined to have an impact on each other's lives. Perhaps we won't know what that impact has been until a year from now, maybe 10 years from now, maybe never. but I do believe that we have affected each other's lives in many, many ways. Another theme in Sharon's speech 20 years ago emphasized the beauty of this place where we find ourselves. As she said in her graduation speech, increasingly I'm aware of how much we also are shaped by our surroundings. When I lived here in Montagnola, I could hardly drink in the beauty of the place. It affected me profoundly, and the beauty of this place has nourished my little heart ever since. Mrs. Fleming made it her mission not only to educate you and to leave the imprint of her red lipstick on your cheeks, but also to beautify your lives. Perhaps you do not know it yet, just how the Villa de Noble, these Swiss hills, those Sant'Evonio bells have affected you, changed you, shaped you, but I am sure that they have. I am absolutely certain of it. And Mrs. Fleming was right. You need and deserve this beauty. And you will take it with you when you leave, for it is now part of you, just as your friends and teachers are all part of you. Yes, graduates, Sharon and I are both happy to be back in this beautiful spot with you. And we are very pleased that many twists of fate have brought us here to celebrate our 34th wedding anniversary with you tomorrow. As we also, more importantly, celebrate your graduation from TASIS. In closing, I want to talk about another very special twist of fate. Back in 1983, my first year as headmaster, one of the first diplomas I awarded in my long career as a headmaster was to Farid Shahin. When I decided to leave retirement after 5 years to return to Lugano as headmaster, I was delighted to learn that Farid's daughter, Daphne, was a member of the graduating class of 2016. Think about it. This is the first time in my career when I will be presenting a diploma to the child of a parent who also received a diploma from me. In many ways, I feel like my career has come full circle. I'm gratified that Farid experienced something so special here, even when the campus didn't have all of these beautiful buildings, that he wanted his daughter to have a similar experience. I like to think that it was much more than just the strong education that Farid received here, but he also wanted Daphne to come to TASIS for the beauty of the place and the people. As Mrs. Fleming said to students in a speech in 1981, and perhaps Farid was in the audience, think beautiful. There's no stronger enemy of ugliness than beauty. Be that beauty physical in a sense of space that you create around you, or spiritual in the universe of your mind, in the sense of what man's spirit, your spirit, can achieve. I think that Mrs. Fleming's vision is captured poignantly on one of the plaques outside the Shahin Arts Center. The plaque contains a quote from the 13th century Persian poet Rumi. It says simply, "Let the beauty we love shine in what we do." Graduates, I can think of no better words to leave you with as you say farewell to TASIS tomorrow. Let the beauty we love shine in what we do. Thank you very, very much. Now my pleasure to introduce our Masters of ceremony, our MCs. Tonight's MCs were selected by a vote of the faculty and their classmates. Normally, we only have one MC, but many people, both people, will not be surprised to learn that these two young men will be sharing the honor tonight. Stan Duryakov and Eddie Sella have been friends for many years since the middle school here at TASIS. They have been such good friends over the years that their names are usually linked. Stan and Eddie, or Stanetti, or Steady. And their nationality is Russian-Italian. Stanetti are so closely linked that they were elected co-presidents of this year's student government. Stanetti were the first seniors to visit me when I became headmaster this year. They came to my office one morning this past summer to introduce themselves and to let me know about some of their ideas. I was very impressed, except for the fact that one of them almost fell asleep in my office. He clearly was not used to getting up for an 11 o'clock meeting on his summer holiday. I won't tell you who he was, but it wasn't Stan. I'm certain that Stanetti will both stay awake tonight and also keep us awake as they serve as our MC. It's an honor to ask Stanetti to come to the podium. Thank you very much.
Welcome Yumi Dondo to the stage. Good evening, Mrs. Ashelman, Mr. Rigg, teachers, families, and class of 2016. My name is Yumi Dondo, and tomorrow will mark the end of my three-year journey at TASIS. Journey, yes, it was quite the journey, with several obstacles, downfalls, and accomplishments. It all began when I attended summer camp in Switzerland, and I became enchanted by the possibility of making friends from various parts of the world. And to me, that was the greatest memory to bring home every summer. Until the day I decided to expand those memories and live like that every day. I wanted to be able to wake up and go to class and listen to several different languages, learn about different cultures, and most importantly, about diverse perspectives on life. TASIS to me was my school, my home, and where I learned so many life lessons as a result of being part of this community. Here, I did not only learn about the martial learner condition in economics, or how to find a way to discover the employee Wi-Fi password every single time they changed it, in order to download that season of Keeping Up with the Kardashians. But here, I learned how to become an adult. I learned how to face all kinds of problems and how to go through difficult moments away from my family. And I am sure every TASIS student did so as well. However, what differentiates TASIS from any other school is that we did not have to go through this alone. Since our first day of class until our last, we always had the support of the TASIS community. And every individual, every obstacle, every victory taught us a lesson. However, as every lesson learned, it can sometimes be forgotten, especially in our situation where we are beginning a new chapter of our lives, where we will have to face new obstacles and eventually fulfill new accomplishments. So today, I'm here to share a small reminders list I created so we do not forget the lessons we learned at TASIS, the lessons that made us who we are today and that brought us here today. The first reminder on my list is to maintain your perseverance. Initially, my intention was to spend 1 year at TASIS, yet when I saw all the opportunities TASIS offered me and all the doors it opened, I decided to complete my high school years here. But the path wasn't as easy as it seemed. Being away from my family, childhood friends, the comfort of my home, were all difficult obstacles I had to overcome. Being here today demonstrates our perseverance. It demonstrates how each of us were capable of achieving a certain goal. And even though each of us did it in a different way, the one thing we have in common is that we finally made it today. So never forget to maintain your perseverance. My second reminder is to always put yourself in others' shoes. In any other school, I would normally see my friends from 8 in the morning until 3:45 in the afternoon. I did not know what they had for dinner, or how late they'd be up studying, or how they were dealing with their different struggles. However, at TASIS, we see each other from 7:30 in the morning until 10:30 at night. We share every meal together. We cry together, we laugh together. But at times, we have different struggles or frustrations. TASIS showed me how it is imperative to do my best to understand people's different battles. And most importantly, to be as supportive as possible to those around me. Because after crying for 2 hours before an IB exam, the best thing was to go down to check in and have a hug or even a smile of a friend or a dorm parent and know that they understood what I was going through. So my second reminder is to always put yourself in others' shoes. My third reminder is listen. After 3 years of having Dr. Love as a teacher, by my second year, I was able to understand the importance of listening. I had this extremely annoying tendency of always saying, okay, I understand, or yeah, I got it. And one day, Dr. Love taught me to take a step back, have a moment before verifying that I understand. Because to be honest, most of the times, I actually didn't. And so when I applied this to my everyday life, I realized how much more I got out of my conversations, whether it was with friends or teachers. As Larry King once said, nothing I say this day will teach me anything. So if I'm going to learn, I must do it by listening. My fourth reminder is to always keep your loved ones close. By having many friends coming and going, I realize how important it is to remind them how much they mean to you. Because at the end of the day, they're the ones who will lift you up and push you forward. If it weren't for my mother, my sister, my best friend Felipe, and my boyfriend Paolo, I don't think I would have been able to sanely complete the IB. At times, I would call them crying and sobbing, and they either listened to me attentively, like Felipe and my sister, or remind me that I must relax, like Paolo, or abruptly cut me off and say, "You may get out of your bed, take a cold shower, and get over it." And if you know her, you could have easily guessed that's what my mom said. So due to the people I met at TASIS, I became who I am today and learned to have different outlooks on life. Here at TASIS, I learned the importance of keeping those you love near you, to remind them how much they mean to you, whether they're new friends, old friends, or family. Therefore, always remember to cherish your loved ones. My fifth reminder is to realize the significance of happy moments and learn how to value them. I had to make many sacrifices while at TASIS. There were various occasions where my friends would travel, go downtown to dinner, and I wasn't able to attend because I was busy studying for a test the next day. These sacrifices taught me the importance of valuing every moment of life. I learned how to value the happy moments of life, as well as to value being near people I love. Like every morning arriving into economics class and screaming, "Moonzi Poonzi!" And although I wasn't able to attend every single trip for every single dinner, I felt like I did not miss the chance of being happy by valuing every moment. Therefore, my fifth reminder to all of you is to value the happy moments in life. Because as the end approaches, these valued moments will become our good memories in the future and will remind us of the place we once called home. And last but not least, on the days when you miss TASIS or you're just having a bad day, my final reminder to all of you is to allow yourself the Nutella crepe. Thank you. E obrigada, mamusha, ficho, tata, Paulo, babote e tia Cláudia.
Nonetheless, he has managed to be recognized in the TASIS community and spheres in his brief year, and so he will now teach us that failure is never the end. So please give a round of applause for Sam.
Having been the second speaker of the night, there's some pressure to outdo my predecessor, Yumi. That was a wonderful speech. Mr. and Mrs. Eshelman, Mr. Rigg, faculty, family, and friends, I am Samuel Owusu-Agyemang, and I would like to thank you for the opportunity to speak tonight. 17 hours in transit from Lusaka, Zambia to Lugano, Switzerland. Tiring journey, but boy was I excited to post my first Switzerland-bound photo on Instagram. Making the spontaneous decision to leave Africa to attend an $80,000 school in Switzerland made me extremely anxious for two reasons. Firstly, I'll be leaving the comfort of my home and live in dorms and socialize in class with people who I do not know and who have a completely different culture than my own, or so I thought. Secondly, I was anxious about coming to TASIS because I wasn't sure how to fit in and build my character while also keeping close to my roots. I asked myself, how will I balance the old Samuel with the new? I quickly learned that TASIS was the best decision I could have made. An American atmosphere complemented by an array of cultures from all over the world, all collectively structured in the Italian canton of Switzerland, has been a great gift to me. The person I was becoming before I arrived at TASIS had a strange beginning. I think most of my fellow seniors here can relate to some of my things. And when reflecting on the journey so far, I noted that the biggest triumphs all came from one or two imminent failures. If I think back to my first few years of high school, they were a breeze. I was successful in school, but I had little understanding of life outside. As a result, things changed when I got a taste of the business world. In the ninth grade, a group of boys and I got together and tried to start a little business. We loved entertainment, and the only thing we could do was throw some parties. So guess what we did? We threw parties. Here, there, and everywhere. Obviously, my grades took a bad turn as a result. Organizing parties wasn't good enough for us, so we decided to plan a music concert. So one morning, after walking to the front of my parents' bedroom door and turning back at least 6 times, I eventually had the courage to go in and tell my father, "Dad, I need $60,000. I had done my research on how much Big Sean, an American rapper, charges for a concert, and it was $60,000. So I presented my very amateur and juvenile proposal, and well, I failed to get the money. But this story isn't about how I could throw the best parties or how not to get $60,000. It's about how failure changed my life. This was when I first felt a burning desire for business and entrepreneurship. Although after that turnaround, failure still kept knocking me. I applied to the best school in America, Phillips Academy, Andover, and got rejected twice. More failure, but this time it was public. You see, I was starting to experience more and more failure in all shapes and sizes. But in hindsight today, I now realize that failure is one of the most important things that can happen to a young adult. And as Sylvester Stallone once said in the movie Rocky, it's not about how hard you hit, it's about how hard you can get hit and keep moving forward. The period between that day and today have resulted in me inventing a system that can potentially solve Africa's energy problem. To avoid more math and physics for my fellow seniors tonight, in summary, I've utilized various technologies in the world today and created an interconnected system that made it possible for me to reduce the cost of producing electricity in Africa for 1/20th of the current price of electricity in Africa. Failure and the way I got right back up after it knocked me down got me here today. I failed many times in the past 3 years working on this project, and I still have many big obstacles ahead of me, but failure will not stop me. And any failure you, my fellow seniors, experience in the next few years should not stop you, but should keep building you and helping you move forward even more. In the process of writing this speech, a period of deep reflection ensued. And I'm not going to give any shout-outs tonight, but many individuals both here in this hall and abroad have contributed to my growth in the past 9 months. Fellow seniors, our teachers deserve a round of applause for not only making us better scholars, but also influencing us in many ways. Their tough tests remind us that regardless of how it goes down, life goes on. Besides motivating me to impact the world as greatly as I possibly can, TASIS has reassured me that anything in life, as Nelson Mandela once put it, always seems impossible until it's done. Thank you, Mom and Dad, for bringing me here. Thank you, Kyla, for reminding me to keep breathing. And thank you to Class of 2016 for the memorable experience. Good night.
Is the founder's club, if you even remember what that is. And it's an idea that we had in the beginning of the year, which we thought would catch on with ease, but it did not happen. People did not want to do it, so we did not really carry through it. And we would like to apologize for that. But if anyone is still interested, Team 1 won. So if you're in Team 1, if you even remember what Team 1 is, you can go celebrate tonight with your parents. And I'm paying.
Our next speaker is Carmen. Woo-hoo! Carmen is from Texas and has been at TASIS for 3 years. In these 3 years, she has managed to be recognized for numerous academic and community awards. In turn, she would like to explain to us why it's the little things that count. We would now like to welcome our salutatorian to the stage, Carmen Alban.
Thank you, Eddie. Okay, now we're ready. Good evening, everybody. I'm sorry that I don't have a cool accent like Samuel does, but I hope you'll listen to me anyway. I know it's pretty cheesy to start a speech off with a quote, but this has been a longtime favorite of mine, so I'm gonna start my speech with a quote anyway. Rose Kennedy said, "Life isn't a matter of milestones, but of moments." I believe that it's these moments that go unrecognized. It's these experiences that have all been gathering towards this one day, this one time in our lives, where we get to celebrate all the great times and all the not so great times about our time at TASIS. It's been these small moments that have shaped who I am. I've grown into a person, sad to leave, but I'm excited to see what's next. The small moments at TASIS have shown me that it's the people here that are what make it so amazing. It's every wave from a teacher or every smile from a friend that remind me how lucky I am to be here. And knowing that our moments are quickly coming to an end, I have to remember to love all of these smiles and all of these waves. I have to remember to smile back every time. Some of us have had over 8 years, some of us 11, of moments at TASIS. Some of us have had only a few months. But all of us can agree that it's the relationships we form through these moments that truly matter, and they're what we will miss the most. In this class, we have every type of person from every country. We have talented athletes, we have Molly Hercules and Ivan Ubovich. We have actors and singers that will blow your mind, like Gabby Bertoni and Eddie Stella. We even have the smartest people you will ever meet. That would be Edo Italia and Paulina Gazin. But despite our differences, we all come together to form one class. We're one unit, one machine. But within this mess of personalities and passions, everyone has found their family away from home. And it's the small moments of these families that have shown me how great the TASIS really is. It's times like when I walk into Ginobili for lunch, and I know I'll see the same people at the same table, eating the same food every day. It's knowing that I'll wake up every morning with a text from the same person asking if I'll be at breakfast, and my answer is always the same, but it happens every day. It's every PhD someone buys me, or every time I'm asked if someone can use my elevator pass, which is all of the time. But it's moments like this that have made me realize how great TASIS is, how amazing these students are. We have to look back at these insignificant moments and realize that they're not so insignificant. They're what make this place so amazing. These moments bring us all together. Being so far from home hasn't been impossible with surrogate siblings and parents to help me through. Without Taina, I would be wearing hideous clothing every day. Without Tati, I would go crazy because she listens to all of my rants. Without Alex, no one would understand my southern jokes or agree with me that it's pronounced pecan and not pecan. And without Lauren, I honestly don't think I would have survived junior year. There's so many people here who have made moments with me. So many moments that I look back on and wish I could live them over and over again. But it's not only the moments with my friends at TASIS that matter. It's also the moments with all the teachers here. But the adults at TASIS are more than just teachers. They're advisors and mentors, they're friends. They truly care about all the students both inside and outside of the classroom, and that's what makes TASIS so special. The first interaction I ever had with a teacher at TASIS was with Mr. Freddy. So you can all guess, he was screaming at me. It was my first day here, I was getting off the bus at Ski Week, and I guess I was standing in someone's way, when Mr. Freddy came up to me
and started screaming at me about how stupid I was, and he couldn't believe I'd even gotten accepted into this school. So I was terrified. It's okay, moments later, TASIS redeemed itself when Mr. Locke approached me. He came up and said, "Carmen, are you okay?" Said, "If you need anything, you can talk to me." So first, I was very impressed Mr. Locke even knew my name, because I'd been to school for less than a day. But I was more impressed to know that I was going to be okay, but I didn't make a huge mistake coming here. This is a place where teachers care. This is a place where there's not only long-haired redheads who scream at people. It's okay. Freddie also had a redemption a year later when I was able to have him and Mr. Locke in class. With Mr. Freddie, there was some more yelling. Okay, there was a lot more yelling, but it was still great. It was yelling out of love. There was throwing around Wilson, drinking coffee, stolen PowerPoints, and a lot of history. Mr. Freddie is probably the most passionate teacher I've ever had. He's not afraid to hide his emotions. But that's what makes him so great. He really cares that we learn and not just memorize. After the exam, he seemed genuinely excited that we had done well. With Mr. Locke, class was a little different. There was much less yelling, but it was still 2 years of silent harkness discussions, really bad puns, and off-topic conversation about prison riots and US politics. But it was also 2 years of Mr. Locke continuing to prove how much he cares. He's the only teacher that would make a feast for breakfast at 7 a.m. the morning of the exam. It's moments like this that remind me how great the teachers here really are. It's moments like this that remind me that the adults here are what make it so special. I remember on my first day of advisory, Mr. Moon told me that if I ever found myself crying or in need of help, that I should never, ever go to him. I know that if I was actually needing someone, Mr. Moon would be there. And because this is Mr. Moon's last senior banquet, Mr. Moon, can you please stand up? But it's teachers like Mr. Moon, Mr. Locke, and Mr. Freddie that make this place so special. They're what make every moment here worth remembering. Even though these small moments aren't milestones or big achievements or awards, they're what made my experience at TASIS. It's this accumulation of family-style dinners, academic travels, and coffee from the snack bar that make these days so special and make me realize how much I'm going to miss this place. All of these things strung together have made TASIS the best decision my parents ever let me make. And I have everyone in here to thank for all of these amazing moments, especially my parents. Thank you, Mom and Dad, for letting me come to this amazing school. This has been one of the best 3 years of my life. So I'd like to thank everyone in this room for making all these moments so special. Thank you.
Edoardo Italia, as you might have already guessed, is from Italy and has been at TASIS for 3 years. Edo has definitely left his mark here in TASIS with his many academic and community awards. He is a person that everyone knows, but from a shy boy to a recognized man, Edo wants to remind us how TASIS has changed us. So please welcome Edo on stage.
The love introduction. Oh, this is a very big crowd. It was much smaller before. Okay, before starting, I wanted to congratulate all the speakers tonight. They have been very touching and heartwarming speeches. I would like to, if you could all join your hands together and give a round of applause. Mr. and Mrs. Agyemang, fellow classmates,
friends and family, and staff and faculty, good evening. Now I'm here to talk about how TASIS has changed us, and that is a very interesting question. To answer it, let's do this. All of you, please do me a favor. Close your eyes. Now let me ask you, who were you yesterday, or last year, or for students before you came to TASIS? Now, open your eyes. Right now, we might not realize how much we have changed. And that is why I ask you to think about who you were before today. Because if I look back on when I started here, I can see that I changed so, so much. I found it really difficult to talk to new people. I was very shy. I certainly could not deliver a speech in front of all of you. This makes me remember the boat dance. Oh man, sophomore year when I arrived, new week of school, new people. I completely refused to dance because I was just embarrassed of my dancing skills, which weren't even great at all. I decided to sit down at the table and talk with my friends. But the second year, junior year, with a little bit of peer pressure, I decided to challenge myself and start dancing. I danced a bit awkwardly, but that doesn't matter. Senior year was a great year. First song comes on, and I start dancing the entire night. Dancing so well, or at least so I thought, but that's not the problem, because the truth is that I wasn't worried about being embarrassed anymore. I wasn't worried about what people thought of me anymore. Now, I love talking and meeting new people. I find I was able to transform because I engage in so many different activities. The play, in particular, allowed me to work on my strengths. You know, putting me on stage forced me to evolve. But that's how I changed here. Now, let's talk about us. The 60th and largest graduating class. We might not even remember what happened during these 4 years. Other than studying every single day, we have even endured the 2012 apocalypse. I want to remind you that we danced to the Harlem Shake and heard Dr. Love snap his fingers whenever we said something interesting, possibly about ghosts. We have worked hard for 4 years and are now seeing the results. However, despite all of our achievements, there is still a long and oh my turbulent way to go. So turbulent. As legendary street poet Kanye West puts it, our work is never done. What this refined piece of prose tells us is that we have to keep working and striving towards our ideas and goals, always. But how has TASIS changed us? Now that is the question, not like the Shakespeare thing. TASIS has taught me the importance of following through with all your decisions. Now, let me give you an example. When I first arrived in grade 10, I hated it completely. I did not like the people, I felt uncomfortable, it was such a weird place for me. I told immediately my friend, Jonathan XIE, that I wanted to leave and attend a new boarding school in the UK. After he finished his daily dose of Italia, un esperimento incredibile, he said, Edoardo, what the hell are you thinking? You've been here only for a month. And that was true, I've been here only for a month, but I ignored him completely. I wanted to leave. My parents, like a lot of parents would, supported dubiously my idea of leaving classes. When my interview offer arrived, my father asked me if I was sure what I was about to do. I started to reassess my thoughts regarding my transfer. Imagine what my future would have been like if I had stayed. Well, I mean, obviously I decided to stay, but that is not why I'm telling you the story. And for the fact that I stayed, I would like to thank Jonathan and Mom and Papa for having helped me. If I hadn't stayed, I would have never met all of these amazing people that had such a great impact on my life. Like these people right here. Since that night, whenever I have to make an important decision, I try to imagine myself in the future if that decision were carried out. Being able to make better decisions, I can now connect with people. Instead of sitting head down at the dinner table, staring at my plate, listening to other people laugh while I just eat, I can now challenge myself. I don't have to go through periods such as the boat dance where I just sit down at the dinner table because I'm embarrassed of showing my incredible dancing skills, while people at the other booths just have fun and laugh while I just not do anything. I'm not worried about that. I can show the world who I truly am. This makes me want to say that by giving me opportunities to express myself, TASIS truly has allowed me to discover myself. And today, my 80th birthday, I can finally say that this incredible experience has paid off. And even though the weird and shy Eduardo is still in me, I can't control it. External pressures don't guide me anymore. Now, let me remind you that tomorrow will be a commencement assembly. Commencement. Where a story's beginnings and not their end will be celebrated. Remember the cheerful events that happened and not the sad ones, since you'll probably not even remember why you were sad. Don't forget what TASIS has taught you and how it has changed you. Apply those lessons to your future, and as my man, like Mr. Schwartz would say, Jay-Z puts it, may the best of your todays be the worst of your tomorrows. I would like to thank my family, my friends, and all the people I've met here. You have been an amazing class, and on the notes of the sound of music, let me say, so long, farewell, auf Wiedersehen, adieu, ciao a tutti, Italia out.
It is a song, I Will Remember You, by Sarah McLachlan. Sung by Stasjia, Antonella, Piconi, Lauren Roberts, and Marianne Tissot. Accompanied by Samantha.
much for that wonderful performance. Soon, you will be hearing the final speech from our beloved rapper, Halo Green. Better known as Mr. Locke, the man who excuses your absences and signs your travel forms. Mr. Locke has been at TASIS for 6 years and has stepped up the fashion game ever since. There is not one day where his socks and ties don't match, and who can forget the disco ball suit? Please welcome Mr. Locke on stage.
Good evening. I'm glad to be up here closing the evening for you. Parents, colleagues, honored guests, and most especially, class of 2016. Greetings, thanks, and congratulations. It's a pleasure to be up here addressing you tonight. As great dean of the class of 2016, for the second time around, it is especially satisfying for me to look out among you and see so many of you, so wonderfully accomplished, so well-dressed and happy, and so blessedly close to finally being gone. One of the conventions of this genre is to open with a witty aphorism or quote that has personal meaning, something that will finally help you understand the meaning of life and the secret to being a successful adult, and in doing so, will serve as the basis for the next 45 minutes of lecture. I'm going to deliver on half of that last sentence, so please be comfortable. When I was in 10th grade, I had a geometry teacher named Mr. Cooper. He was like an oracle to me. Just about everything he said knocked me off my feet, and I thought he was just about the smartest guy to ever use the English language. Later, I learned from teaching alongside him that he is better described as a cancer survivor with life experience, wisdom, and perspective to spare. Either way, that hasn't stopped me from remembering something that he told me once that I want to share with you, which is simply this: that it's not important to be serious, but you have to be serious about what's important. That saying, my English teacher is going to show here for a moment, is commonly called a chiasmus, and it comes in two inverted parts, which I'd like to suggest to you now are critical to what we here at TASIS have been trying to show you all along. It may seem now from where you sit that a warning on why it's not important to be serious is completely ridiculous. How could anybody possibly look around your class who so willingly embarrass themselves in a dresser proctor bay, who use sunny afternoons to lounge luxuriously on Lake Lugano, or who cheer like wild animals during the International Week Food Fair, and then say, "Don't forget to be playful." Well, consider this a pre-warning, then, if such a thing exists. Automatically treating everything seriously doesn't happen overnight. As many of you may have noted during the slog of February and March, when there are mock exams, college deadlines, and a million other things to worry about, those unserious moments aren't quite so easy to come by. Going forward, your quote-unquote realize are going to look a whole lot more like February than it will like a sunny afternoon on Lake Lugano. Don't get me wrong, there is much to look forward to about adult life. You make your own decisions, you can drive a car, you can even go off campus during the school day. But that's not to say that there won't be a lot of drudgery, a lot of work, a lot to worry about. Things that you might only know exist in the abstract, things like life insurance premiums, taxes, retirement planning, things that are completely foreign to you now. Well, it piles up. And before you know it, those things could feel like the sum total of your lives. The adults in this room know all too well what I'm talking about, of course, but I bet they also know this. It is from the drudgery in life that you must rescue joy. A goofy dance with your friends, a late night for no good reason, a supremely bad pun, or the occasional education-themed rap video. Sometimes it's not important to be serious. But that's only the half of it. So let me turn now to the second part of the saying. It is easy to understand the notion that you have to be serious about what is important in a number of life-affirming ways.
A short list.
Take your education seriously. Treat your family, your cultural background, your relationships, and your faith the same. That's certainly good advice, and many of you already do. But I'd like for you to consider the second half of this phrase as something other than a list of things that you ought to do. Rather, I'd like you to consider it as a choice you get to make every day about what is important. This choice, about that which you should or should not take seriously, is to me the freedom of the education you've received from TASIS. And it is the freedom that you've received here that we celebrate tonight. When you go, you'll get to decide what causes, what pursuits, and what ideas are worthy of your prodigious talents and your limited time. And it's my contention that your education here, the exposure to the beautiful scenery, the art and architecture, the history, the hard work of your teachers, your classmates, all of that, your experience at TASIS has left you equipped to decide for yourselves what is important, what to value, and how to be unyielding in your pursuit of it. We've offered you some reminders about what to choose. Some are not so subtle, like the printing of Truth, Beauty, and Goodness on the library, or the magnificent 7 awards that we hand out twice a year. But ultimately, the question of what you consider to be important is so essential that you must answer it and know it for yourselves. When you commence tomorrow, that will be the question hanging over you. That will be the rumbling in your stomach. That will be your imperative. And you have a sacred responsibility to choose what's important, to choose well, and to chase it with all the seriousness that you've got. In the meantime, I hope that we've opened every door that we can for you. I wish you joy, even in the drudgery, and of course, all the luck there is. Thank you. Invited out on the terrace for spumante and strawberries. Please enjoy the rest of the evening.